Who is your superhero of all times? Are you into Marvel? Avengers? You like them? Then maybe you are quite young. Or were you more into Superman or Batman? Then your childhood is probably some long time ago. Superheroes in Asia came long before Hollywood. In Japan, we read about them in ancient books in school, even manga comic book, and later we watched many anime and real movies. They are our biggest inspiration as kids. And long before those American creations came into Japan, we had our own heroes. Heroes that are deeply rooted in Asian history and literature. But do you know any tattooed hero in Western culture? We have not only one in Asia, but several. Let's take a look together at our very own Japanese superhero universe. It's called Suikoden. Suikoden is one of the earliest Chinese novels written in the language we now call Mandarin. The title means A Tale by the Waterside, translated as Water Margin, Outlaws of the Marsh and All Men Are Brothers. Maybe you watched the TV version from 1970s? It's called The Water Margin in English. Or maybe you know from PlayStation game. During Edo era, Suikoden got super popular in Japan. The Chinese novel Suikoden was introduced in the early Edo period when it was translated to Japanese. The number of readers gradually expanded with the publication of more readable illustrated reading books. It became fashionable to add beautiful images. And like today, pictures sell more books, right? The first illustrated version came out in 1777, 20 years after the first translation was published. Sekien Toriyama, who is famous for his ghost paintings, wrote a digest picture book. 25 years later, in 1805, Shinpen Suikoden, New Water Margin Legend, was painted, in which famous author Bakin adapted the text and Katsushika Hokusai drew the illustrations. Hokusai still now probably is the most famous ukiyo-e artist of all times. His one artwork everybody knows is The Great Wave of Kanagawa from the series 36 Views of Mount Fuji. About 20 years later, in 1826-27, Utagawa Kuniyoshi came out with his first series of Suikoga, then he hit the jackpot. This series was the first popular colorful ukiyo-e to take up the Chinese tale Suikoden as its subject matter and is considered to be Kuniyoshi's crowning achievement. It made him world famous and it is still the most revered piece of Japanese art for tattoo artists. And at the time, interest in Suikoden was at its peak, so its success was instantaneous. Published in several editions over a 10-year period beginning in 1827, each print fascinated people with its vivid depiction of the character's appearance and activities. In Kuniyoshi's first publication, two of five warriors were illustrated with their tattoos as they were described in the original Suikoden. The first limited series instantly became extremely popular and triggered a tattoo boom in Edo. Quite amazing, a Chinese novel with tattooed heroes helped giving a birth to a Japanese tattoo culture. The characters are Chinese heroes, but the design of the tattoos are in a distinctly Japanese style. And Kuniyoshi applied a very large tattoos that exceeded previously existing concepts of tattooing. Kuniyoshi's greatness then became particularly evident in his following works. He continued illustrating more and more characters with extensive tattoos, even those that were not mentioned in the original text. People started to get bigger tattoos, like we know as Japanese tattoo nowadays. Oh, I need to make another video to show extremely interesting strong connection between ukiyo-e artist and tattoo another time. In any case, Japanese loved the story. We created new versions and even parodies. People mirrored the stories to their own lives and created their own version of it. It is like Japanese curry originally from India, Chinese noodle became Japanese ramen. Japanese are good at learning and adapts all kind of imports to their own interpretation. But why did it become so popular in Japanese tattoo scene and still is now worldwide? There are two reasons. One, there are many heroes in this story. During the late Northern Song Dynasty, a time when corrupt officials and injustice-bound 108 good men gathered at a natural fortress, a mountain surrounded by marshes called Ryozanpaku, they all have been cast out of the mainstream world for various reasons. Together, they survive many adventures and battles, and eventually form a gang that plans to overthrow corrupt officials and to save the country. It's the Avengers meeting four musketeers and Robin Hood. 2. Cool characters. These characters are not honest, pure angel type. Like those diligent ones who studied hard and lived a prosperous, boring life. No, they are the ones good girls fall in love with. And good boys wanted to be like them. So the girls fall in love with them too. You know what I'm talking about, right? Some were even criminal before. Rough guys. Less than perfect. But chivalrous and standing for each other. And that's exactly the reason why they grabbed the hearts of all people back in Ed Age and even now. Some things never change. There are 108 characters altogether in Suikoden, and quite many of them are amazing human beings. You definitely find your favorite character that you can relate yourself to. The Suikoden characters most popular in tattoo world are, of course, tattooed ones. When Kuniyoshi illustrated the Suikoden, he visualized those heroes for us. In the original text, not all tattoos weren't actually mentioned, but somehow Kuniyoshi imagined some of them having tattoos. Today, some historians say that Kuniyoshi himself was tattooed. Or was he even a tattoo artist? Nonetheless, he did create images of tattooed warriors that keep on inspiring us until today. Very soon, Kuniyoshi's ukiyo-e tattooed warriors were used as tattoo design in Japan. Many famous Japanese tattoo artists of the past 100 years and more created amazing artwork based on Kuniyoshi prints. They either used tattoo images of Suikoden characters for tattoos, or they went one step further and tattooed image of warriors on their clients. It became so popular to have tattooed Suikoden heroes tattooed that we even have a name for this in Japanese. It is called Nijubori and means double tattooed, the image within the image. There are many tattooed characters in the story, like Kumonryu Shishin. Kumonryu means nine dragon. He has nine dragons tattooed on his body. He is rather young hero, only 80-90 years old, but fully tattooed. He was one of the first characters to be introduced in the story. The typical bad boy that mom never stops complaining and worrying about. And there was also flower monk Rochishin. He is a tattooed monk, a huge muscular man with such monstrous strength that he can pull out a willow tree by its roots and smash the Nyo statue at the temple gate to pieces with his bare hands. He wanted to help people but killed someone by mistake, and that made him become monk. He loves to drink and finally comes to a mysterious end. The one I will tell you in my next video about in more details is Chojun. He is an excellent swimmer and famous for one dramatic battle that ends his life as a hero. His story is well known as Suimon Yaburi, breaking through the water gate. But I don't want to spoil our next video yet. There are more tattooed characters in the fascinating universe of Suikoden, but those three are the most popular ones. People were always fascinated by other human with full tattooed body. It's a mystery. Why would they endure so much pain for beauty? What does it even mean? Do you also want to get something cool? Someone you respect, admire, and are impressed? Let me know in the comment. I know quite many of you have tattoos. And if you haven't yet, Please subscribe my channel. I cannot wait to introduce about children on my next video. Thank you very much for watching today. Have a good day and have a good night. Bye! またねー!